physical reactions are considered very positive. Various problems in the parts of the body, stomach problems, uterine problems. And they try to find self-treatments. Self-treatments or self-coping treatments, like for example, drinking too much, smoking too much, taking drugs, to try to reduce the stress. And of course, again, the mental illness is up. Now, very simple. Anxiety is the commonest condition that you find in stress. Depression is the second. And actually, psychosis is not very common. Substance abuse is very common, especially smoking and drinking. And personality disorder and psychological problems are there. And child psychological problems, family and child stresses, can be also problems. Anxiety is a psychophysiological response to a psychological stress. Hence the word, some people say, I've got this worryness, too much of worry. Hence the multiple physical symptoms, but no physical disease. Complaining of headaches, stomachache, backache, can't sleep. But actually, there's no disease. And they keep on going to our health, going to doctors, getting tests done, x-ray done, PCR done. But nothing wrong, nothing physically wrong. Mentally, emotionally, and socially, there are stress. You have to really find out what the stress are. Sustained anxiety can produce rejected, hated, restricted outcome, as there is no end to the stress, no right end to the stress. If anxiety or worry continues and continues and continues to develop stress, eventually the person becomes very dejected, very depressed. That's when they have even thoughts of suicide, killing themselves, and so on and so forth. I come from a few students, they have come to the university, they started the music course, and then after 6 months, I want to go. But the parents said nothing to me. So they become depressed and they take it over. If they go home, they'll be in trouble. If they stay on, they cannot concentrate on the studies because that's not the cause they want. So that can lead to the problem. Same thing, marriages are not person, girls forced to get married to a boy because she's going out to some other boy with the parents' object. Then she finds she really doesn't want to be the best in the world. So she takes the advice and ends up in the hospital. And we find that actually the problem started with before she got married, that the parents actually enforced their investment, which she didn't like. So that can be a major cause of this. And then she becomes depressed. These are pictures of depressive masks. You see how the person with depression is off the ground and a few years ago. Famous Hungarian poet by the name of Mandela. He suffered from chronic depression and committed suicide. But he wrote objective poetry in his life. And having his program, the two humanities all broke up because of chronic depression. Suicide is a long term outcome of some of his chronic stresses of suicide. There's ample evidence of close relationship, stress, precipitating of physical disease. Starts off with insomnia, hypertension, coronary artery disease, decreased immunity, autoimmune diseases, stroke, epileptic seizures, migraine, and bioreactivation in the nervous system. And people who are anxious and depressed and chronic stress. So basically, it starts off with anxiety, chronic stress, which gives rise to anxiety, which gives rise to depression, and then insomnia, cardiovascular stress, and then you have heart disease. I come from numerous diseases. Common signs of stress are insomnia or poor sleep. For no reason. There's not no reason. There is something. You just cannot sleep for it. I mean, when you sleep because you're keeping up awake, late to see the World Cup football, that's not the problem. Problem is, when opening is very easy, how to find the problem. Decreased interest, environment, increased normal lifestyle. Preoccupation with autonomic, related function, gastric, cardiac, pain, skin. These are indications that the person is probably under some kind of psychosocial or emotional stress. What causes coronary artery disease? Cerebral artery disease, high cholesterol, lifestyle diseases, eating too much, alcohol, smoking, needs of a son, sexual free, extramarital affairs. None of these people actually have stress. And this is where some people like going to small female, going for a massage and going for prostitutes and all. This advertisement doesn't appear anymore, but the advertisement for massage for those people with sexual dysfunction. And this is often the result of stress. The mental health connection to physical illness is what the definition says. No health without mental health. A lot of the stresses really start in the mind because of psychological and social stress. It's a much neglected aspect of health, seldom measured, hardly evaluated. I'm sure before you join in UTAR, you had to undergo a medical exam. But nobody checked to find out if you're mentally healthy or not. So some of you may be mentally unhealthy, but you're still in UTAR. In fact, to reassure you, even if you join universities and academic staff, or join government services or doctor, nobody does a test for your mental health. They only test your physical health. So some people may not be mentally fit to work a job. Mental health is closely related to physical health, not recognized. Early signs of mental illness manifest by behavior changes, more than physical changes. Gradual behavior change will improve your health, self-cure, substance abuse, cigarettes, alcohol, and drugs. This is reduction attempts by substance abuse improves high pressure foods, sugars, salty foods, overeating. High risk taking behavior sports, outlet for stress, variation for stress, outlet for progress of your body, and links to illnesses. At least 25% of all primary care attendants, people going to PhD, have a psychological reason for attending the medical. About 25% to 30%. With a physical complaint, you come with complaint of headache, tummy, but actually it's not physical. So, some people say the best thing to look at is if somebody comes with a headache, and you can't find it. Who's sitting on the bed? And if you complain of chest pain, who's giving a heart ache? Somebody is affecting your heart. And stomach aches? What can't your stomach? That's one thing. So, the World Federation of Mental Health actually has come up with a to basically ask the question, how mentally healthy are you? Begin. Three questions they ask in detail are, how do you feel about yourself? How do you feel about others? And how do you need to answer what you feel like? Most people can answer how do you feel about yourself is in their own. How do you feel about others is in front of them? That person is trying to achieve the and when it comes to how you need to manage to do their life, a lot of people find it very difficult to cope with their life. But their family, their children, their finances, their job, their studies, and so on. So, if you add the whole lot to your family, not many people are all that mentally helpful. Physically, they're very helpful, but mentally, they're not helpful. Very good. He invented jogging as well. Sport. Now he went through two divorces and finally died from doing jogging. And he had suffered from anxiety depression. He found that then jogging actually made him concentrate on the jogging and less on the stress and produce more endorphins in the body, which actually made him feel better with the endorphins. Eventually he died from it. So now we come to this. How do we prevent stress? Prevention, how do you prevent stress? I mean, prevention is always better than cure. Now, the basic principle is this. You must balance your life. In diet, in exercise, in work, in rest, in relationship. You cannot just eat me forever or speak early. You cannot eat too much of that for sure. You cannot do exercise and do not rest. You must be prepared for accidents, natural, no matter how balanced your life is, there will always be disasters, always surprises, always situations that you must prepare for. control to help build up reserves. If the worst happens, I still have something to fall back. If you reach a level where you say, if I lose my job, I'm finished, that means you're not prepared. And of course, if you lose job, for example, right now, because of the oil crisis, hundreds of oil workers have been laid off. Thousands of them worldwide. They said, you can't afford to, you know, hire these people because they get so little profit. They said, if the oil price drops below $40, it's not profitable to pump our oil. You might as well set the dollars and keep the oil until the price comes up. Why should you pay them salaries every month? So these are some of the reserves that you have got to have to make you survive to a price. Principles of mentalizing balancing choices of people. This is what the Buddhist philosophy is all about. You take the middle part. Don't go into making profit, money, making profit, making money, making money, making money. Or turning to God all the time, but don't make profit. That is a war. So basically, you have to balance it. Know your limits. Control expectations. Control limits. Too much of going and under. No bosom friend of the main bosom friend. No enemy of the main enemy. No in politics. Nobody is the permanent friend and nobody is the permanent enemy. So you can see that in his work. At one time, he was very fond of Android. It was he who brought Android into the government. Later on, now he was arch enemy. Kapha Baba wants his rival. They call Kapha Baba the best friend. So like that, things can change, and that is true even in our relationship. If you invest too much in somebody as a friend, you'll be surprised when the relationship breaks up. But you shouldn't be open to that kind of stress. So prepare for losses in relationships and positions. Not to be pushing your fall. Question your greed, for instance, that you need to understand and work with balance. Train yourself to be the tolerant, learn to accept it. Challenges which is the transfer. So very carefully attach yourself. Invest more in selfless heart. This is roughly what I mean by this. You have to have some time for work, some time for yourself, some time for home. And sometimes outside work, you're outside work. In other words, participate in something. Sports, religious activities, voluntary work, helping the others, that kind of thing. In those days, the ship was like this. The ship was big, open, any kind of vessel. Religious education. Every religion is a religion. Christianity, Islam, forces everything? Isn't it Jinsky? Force is still the same master force. Holiday? Can a holiday change the nagging mother in law? No way. So it's a temporary thing, relief for a few days. You come back, mother in law getting worse. So this kind of fact solution, I see them very often. Take a holiday, go for a job, listen to good music. After listening to good music, you listen to the bad nagging of your wife. What can you do? You have to cope with that. Then comes the last one, meditation. Then we can have anxiety medicine. They reduce the effects of stress. That's needed as much as possible. There are large quantities of medication. Quite safe, otherwise. You may need antidepressants or Prozac if you respond to the level of depression. Less needed as a cause of stress and war. Even the US military uses Prozac for stress in the army. No quick cure. The way to discover it is not the first. You can find a way to overcome the problem of personality, problems, babies, and work, drugs, and administration. Not the answer. Too many people. Too many people cannot solve the problem, so we all survive the stress. All religions are the best stress therapy. We practice sincerely and daily, not before exams. I think most of us turn to God when we are exams. God, God, please help me pass the exam. I'll do anything for you. You know, somebody gave me a joke word and said, I'm sure it was. The fisherman is going to sea, and storms happen, terrible storm, and the boat overturned, would lose all his fish, and he went down. Oh God, please save me. If you save me, I'll give you everything I have. So God heard him and said, stop the storm, put the fellow back to shore, and bring him back to shore. After he came back, he went to the fellow and said, well, actually, I'm not that rich, I can't give you everything I have. If I give you everything, then I got nothing. So, like that, when exams come, don't promise, go to church regularly, go to temple regularly, go and say, okay, mom, help me a lot. And then, until exam is over, at last you heard of God. Until your wife kicks you out of the house, and then you call it. That kind of religiousness is religion. You must practice the principles of religion, which is do good, don't do bad. Don't be greedy, give more than you receive. Now, that is the real principle. So, the last slide is, when I was talking to Catherine, I saw this mirror. Basically, it said, this man is responsible for your safety. I think there was a mirror. I see no man, except me. And I realized what the mirror was about. The safety in this railway station depends on you. Now, change it. This man is responsible for your stress. You are responsible for your own stress. Learn how to prevent stress.